Hello, my name is Andrew Bryce from the Suffolk Escape. We've got some log cabins here based on our farm in Suffolk for self-catering accommodation. And in these, we have these wood stoves. We thought it'd be useful to make a short video showing how to light a wood stove, both for our guests and anyone else that might find this of use. Well, the most important thing about any fire is the fuel you're burning. Here at the log cabins, we give our guests three types of wood. There's the main logs, which here is a mixture of predominantly ash and alder at the moment. So that's what we've had available from the farm and has been seasoned over the last couple of years. But then importantly, your starter wood is your traditional kindling. And then here we have what I call your starter wood. This is actually some old fencing posts, but they're very dry and it's very easy to get a fire started with these. If you try and start your fire with your main logs at the bottom, then they're going to smoulder away and take a while to get going. These are our wood stoves here. These are Charnwood C4s. They're great little stoves. Don't give out too much heat because these log cabins are very well insulated. Plus they've got central heating. So we need a little stove, but easy to use. So these have one simple control. They have an air vent on the bottom. You pull it out to start it and slide it in when it's going. So to light the stove, open the door, put two pieces of the starter wood in. And then here, we offer our guests the use of fire lighters. We find it's an easy way to start a fire, and Zip particularly we find are very instant lighters. You can use newspaper if you prefer, but here we like to make things nice and simple for our guests. We just take a couple of fire lighters, put them on top of the starter wood, light those up. So we prefer the Zips, they're very quick, easy lighting, and you're away. Once that's going, it's then a question of putting on your kindling. Again, we've got some really nice dried offcuts of timber. Place those on. The best way to do this, we find, is to do a crisscross along one level and then another set over the top. What we're going to do now is put on one more piece of starter wood on top. The reason for that is, I think it's called a Scandinavian way of starting a fire, is we'll then get pine on the top, pine on the bottom, pine in the middle and kindling, and that's going to get going really quickly. So then we shut the door, always burn with the door closed on wood stoves. Make sure air vent is out, here we've just got the one control, and then you can see that's ticking away nicely. So here we go, the fire's going well now. We'll give that about another 5-10 minutes, and then we can start by putting on some of our bigger logs. Well, I hope you found this video of use. If you want to come and stay in a cosy log cabin, please visit our website, suffolkescape.co.uk. And also, you'll find other videos we're going to put on our YouTube channel, and hopefully some will be of use to you as well. But hope this has helped. Bye for now.